All right. Well, just in case anybody's still watching, Rich Mack here. How you guys doing? I just realized I had my microphone turned off the whole time, and I'm not gonna restart. Not for a microphone. Got to see how pleasant it was without my voice blabbering away the whole time. So, a belated welcome to leg number 25 of our Around the World journey. We started off in Tirana, Albania, headed to Taranto, Italy. Not Toronto, Canada, Taranto, Italy, T-A-R-A-N-T-O. So, as I've been saying, and I just realized now my microphone's off, but I had been saying, one thing I screwed up, I think, is I forgot to turn on live weather. I was surprised when I hop back in the sim and the weather had changed so dramatically because, of course, when I just landed, it was raining, pouring. Well, not pouring, but it was raining and cloudy, and you had the constant lightning, which is a sign you have live weather on. Whenever you have any clouds and live weather, you get lightning out of them right now. It's just a bug, and I'm not getting any lightning from any of these clouds. But that's telling me I forgot to turn the live weather on. Let me try to remember what I was talking about and get back to it. So we're heading across the Adriatic today. We're leaving Albania. We're flying west. It's a quick shot across the Adriatic, only about 136 miles. So I'm thinking it's going to be about across the water itself, maybe half an hour or so. A little further than the English Channel. Taranto is in the southern heel of the Italian boot. We'll go back in real quick and take a look at it. So as you can see there by the map, let's focus in. I think we're already a good chunk of the way across right now. We're heading right across the southern tip of the Adriatic. We're going to get to Capo, which will be on the coast of the Italian boot, and Taranto is on the west side of that. Let's go back outside. Hit the button. Taranto is a major port city in Italy. As I was explaining earlier, it was founded, I think, around 800 BC by the Spartans, which is just cool. Any place founded by the Spartans has got to be cool. Toronto was also the site of a major battle in World War II. The British attacked the Italian fleet and knocked out three battleships, all with torpedoes, which I think surprised the Italians too, because Toronto was a rather shallow port. And I don't think they expected torpedoes to be able to work. Probably, I don't know, I really don't know the details, but they may have done the same thing the Japanese did in Pearl Harbor and added fins to their torpedoes. So when they hit the water, they didn't dive so deep and hit the bottom. But I could be wrong. I have no idea. I'm just speculating. I really didn't look that up. But anyhow, you're probably not here to learn about World War II naval warfare. You're here to watch a flight. It's also saying, I can't believe we've made it 25 legs. The quarter century mark. Been quite a flight so far from the east coast of the United States across Canada. Well, up along the Canadian Maritimes, across Greenland and Iceland, and then the UK, down through Western Europe, across the Alps, down the Adriatic, and now we're heading back to the Italian boot, which is somewhere out there behind those clouds. Actually, can we see it? It's still too hazy out there. Still too far away. We're getting there, though. So again, it's going to be a little bit of a shorter leg, about 136 miles, I think, is what I actually had it plugged out to be. Yep, 136 miles. It is little after 1 o'clock now on the afternoon of the 7th day of our flight. Starting to fly into the setting sun. It doesn't look like there are really any major elevations around the airport in Toronto that are going to be in the way. So we should be pretty clear. I was under the impression that the Italian Peninsula is going to be a little more hillier than that, but apparently not, at least that area. curious what kind of detail there was in the open water. I'm not sure what those little loops on the frame are. Right above that back window. There's one on either side. It might be... I wonder if they're just grab handles for when you get up on the wing. So, that's the footrest to step up onto the wing. Maybe that's there so you can grab that to stabilize yourself on the footrest. That must be what it's for. Otherwise, I really don't see any legitimate purpose for them. Inside real quick and just see how far we have to go to Capo once we cross over Abadie. Capo is pretty much the midway point between Abadi and Mesak, so give me a really good idea of pretty much how far we have to go till we're ready to land. Miles, 12 minutes. Yeah. right there along the coast. I'm not sure who that is. Easy. So one thing I'll have to remember when I land at Toronto is that the airport is a shared-use airport. It's military and civilian. All civilian aircraft will taxi to the left off of runway 35. I'm landing on runway 35, and I taxi to the left. Or else I might get shot. I'm just going to try to creep my way under this cloud layer. I hate flying into clouds. Well, hello, Italy. Well, I don't know much about Brindisi, so I don't have much to say. Looks like they're decent port facilities. Interesting location for the airport there. You got a few runways, it's a nice airport. Be a cool approach right over the water. Hey. 21 miles, 8 minutes. Yeah, much flatter than I thought it would be. I really thought it was going to be more mountainous. Didn't realize it was this flat with this much farmland. See if I can use that. It's a little bit of a different screenshot. funny. You got a lot of the old the roads, the crooked roads, the old little cow path roads, and then you have these long straight roads. If I was a betting man, I'd say the long straight roads are either A, new highways, or B, old Roman roads, because Romans loved straight roads. Straight roads were efficient. Yeah, I don't know why. I expected southern Italy to be browner, not so green. Look at it. It's straight road. I would think that would be a Roman road. Same with that one out there. Reduce the throttle a little bit. I'm gonna slow down. I wonder what that is. Quarry, maybe? No, it's not the quarry. I don't know what that would be. Curve up. Speed's looking good. We get the Mesax. I think we're only going to be about 5 miles out, so we got to get ready. In fact, is that the airport right there? That would be about right. Yep. Lights on. Harbor up there at Taranto. that far out. We'll go flaps one. And the whole idea is to stay ahead of the plane. Don't fall behind it. I may actually take over by hand. Gear. I'll let it do the honors of lining me up with the runway, and then I'll take over. Plane. Drift too far to the right, got a crosswind component blown left to right. Alright, landing flaps. Lights, gear, flaps, we're good. Around stuff off screen and I'm all over the place. Let's get back in line here. Bouncing around a lot. For once, I'm on the glide path. Nope. skipped it, but could have been worse. Alrighty. Number left. We are going left. Not allowed to go right. Come to a stop and get stuck. And we'll come right up here. Hang out somewhere near that fuel truck. Get a couple guys on the tarmac I'm gonna run over. Stay away from them if I can. Go over here. In fact, let's go right between these two guys. No, we'll go to the left. Plenty of room up here. Why squeeze in? Alright, and there you have it, folks. We are in Taranto, Italy. Take a look around. Beautiful Taranto, Italy. And that was leg number 25. We are 25 full legs into this flight. Folks, I thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed it and hope to see you back for the next one. Thank you.